What's up, guys? Welcome back to another Stay Fresh production. Before we begin, take a look at this. Look at this bundle of cuteness right here. Say hello to Penny.
Now I know you ain't putting me in this video.
All right, we're back. Today I want to bring you guys a little bit of a new series to the channel. This is a series where I'm going to highlight fragrances that aren't really talked about all that much in terms of a dedicated video review here in the community. And we're starting it off with a fragrance I've talked about a lot since I got it, over a year ago, and I've been really enjoying it since then. It's a staple for the spring. It was included on my 4 for Life list. It was included on my top spring list. You know, it's making all the ranks. And we're talking about, as you can see from the title, from the house of Martin Margiela, this is At the Barbers. Yes. I don't know what I'm gonna call this series yet. I think it'll be in the title. I'll be thinking about it before I release the video, so you'll already know by now, but right now, I have no idea. This fragrance was released 2014. Perfumer is Louise Turner. Now, Louise Turner has actually done quite a few reputable fragrances from different houses, done a lot of fragrances from Jo Malone, some stuff from Mugler for the women's collection. Also did a bunch of the Good Girl fragrances from Caroline Herrera, as well as Fahrenheit 32 from Christian Dior. I actually haven't smelled that one, but that one is talked about here and there in the community. Louise has also done 2 fragrances for the house of Margiela, one of them being At the Barbers. The other one I think is Lazy Sunday, something like that. I don't remember the name. Lazy Sunday Walk, Lazy Sunday, I think that's what it is. Anyway, if you haven't heard about this fragrance, then you haven't been watching my channel. So if you're new to the channel, welcome. Here we stay fresh. That's why this is a Stay Fresh production. So as you can see on the label, these fragrances are meant to depict a particular time period and a particular place. Here you can see, I'm reading it in reverse. It's called At the Barbers, obviously. Madrid 1992, it's supposed to smell like shaving foam and leather, I think. Yeah, leathery notes, and they say it's a male fragrance. So obviously you can wear whatever you want. Fragrance has no gender, just personality. I heard that actually from a user here in the community by the name of I Am The Job. So I'm not taking credit for that. I thought that was an awesome phrase. I saw it commented somewhere. So I Am The Job, you're a real one. Really quick, I'm gonna spray this on just to give myself a reminder of the opening, and I'll talk about the notes a bit. Yes. So on the top, we get bitter orange, peppermint, and black pepper. Oh man, this is so good. In the heart, we get rosemary, we get some geranium and lavender, which is a big note. And in the base, we get tonka bean, leather, and musk. Now, if you didn't know, this is an aromatic fougere. I don't know if I mentioned that already.
You didn't.
An aromatic fougere is essentially a type of fragrance formula, and it features main notes of lavender, tonka bean, and oak moss. And a lot of times they throw in some kind of spice in there just to, you know, spice things up, obviously. So this has those 3 pivotal notes, again, with the addition of the spice, the black pepper. But it has some other things, some herbal nature to it, you know, and it also has a musky nature to it in this case. So at the top, it comes off super fresh, very uplifting, a little creamy. It's definitely spicy with the pepper, the citrus. It's there, it's kind of in the background. As it starts to dry, it stays sweet and fresh and creamy. It literally smells like a shaving foam. Literally like a white and creamy, fresh, a little bit sweet men's shaving foam. Now, if you've never smelled that, it might sound weird that you would want to smell that way, but trust me, it is incredible. It's such a well put together type of scent. You smell well groomed, you smell like a gentleman. I love that. Now, this fragrance is immediately gonna remind you, if you've smelled any of these scents, of fragrances like Rive Gauche from YSL, like Invasion Barbare from MDCI Parfums, all in this barbershop vein in the aromatic fougere family. But it is known to have more of a resemblance to YSL's Rive Gauche, if anything. I haven't smelled that one in a long time, actually. So I need to get my nose on it and do a side by side. So essentially, again, smells like fresh and sweet and creamy, a little bit herbal shaving foam. Really pleasant, really nice, and pretty strong, at least for the first spray. You know, it'll kind of fill up a room. Now, as it starts to dry, the lavender begins to peek its head and it takes over the scent. It takes over everything. It's front and center. It's fresh. It's a little soapy. It's what you would expect from lavender, but it's mixed very well. Still has this creamy backbone to it, which is really nice. And the tonka bean is keeping it sweet, which I love. Now, as it continues to dry, into the further dry down, that leather is going to come out. Now, you really got to appreciate leather, and it's going to come out front and center. It's going to move everything else out of the way. It's going to replace that creaminess a little bit as it starts to dry. In the deep dry down, we're left with basically a musky, leathery sweetness. You know, the tonka bean, the musk, and the leather are there. I don't really get much oak moss, to be honest. I might get it more in the heart, honestly, more of this herbal nature, but that could be coming from the rosemary, which I think it does. The rosemary really tends to make this a little bit more on the mature side, so it doesn't get too sweet and too just out of control sweet and creamy. That herbal nature really does help to ground it a bit. So once again, leather takes over, and that's what you're left with. And the description of this is perfect: shaving and leathery notes. That's mostly what you get in terms of bookending the scent. Starts out shaving, foaming like, ends with the leather. And that encapsulates the scent very well. Now, in terms of performance, this thing actually is no slouch. It is an eau de toilette. For me, it lasts at least 7 hours on my skin. Projection is decent. Between 2 and 3 hours, the first 2 and 3 hours, it will push out. People will detect it. And I get a lot of compliments with this one. This one gets well noticed. And again, it's hard to not like. Who wouldn't like this? You smell like you just left the barbershop, smelling fresh and clean. And if you look the part, oof, you're killing them. So they better look out. Retail, this fragrance is a little pricey for the designer side of things. I think it goes over $100, maybe $120 retail in the store, like at Sephora, or it's easiest to find at Sephora. That I do know. I haven't really looked anywhere else for it. And it is a little hard to find online discounted, at least the last time I looked. I ended up finding this on eBay for under $100. Not that much under $100, but definitely cheaper than going into the store. So I got a little lucky with that. It was a tester bottle, but I really don't mind. So I would sample it. Go and check it out. Put it on your skin, on your hand. You can get a carded sample. Those are easy to come by. And really see what you think. It's really an easy fragrance to wear, a no-brainer for any time of the day, just about any occasion. It does have a bit of an elegance to it, even though it is kind of fresh and casual. And again, perfect for the spring and even great for the summer too. So check out At The Barbers from Margiela if you haven't already. If you have checked it out, please let me know down in the comments what you think. I love this fragrance and I love talking about it, so let's have a conversation. Anyway, thank you guys so much for tuning in to this new series. I got a couple more fragrances in my collection in mind that I plan to do dedicated reviews on. Make sure you stay tuned and make sure you subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you guys so much. Peace. I'll see you guys in the next one.